So we've talked about a few design patterns with MapReduce. We've talked about filtering patterns, summarizing patterns, and structural patterns. But what good are they? Well, these patterns can be thought of as sort of lenses to try and view your problems through. If you have a big data problem and you're trying to do some analysis, that at its heart is really about filtering, about selecting from a large data set and getting some smaller sample of that data set, there's a good chance that you can use this filtering pattern. Likewise, if the fundamental nature of your problem is summarizing or going from a structured to hierarchical sort of database. In fact, these aren't all the patterns you might want to use. There's also organizational patterns. There's patterns that deal with input and output, and there's others. But getting yourself to ask this question, getting yourself to say, is this problem I'm dealing with filtering or summarizing or structural or something else? That isn't simple. In fact, just identifying when MapReduce is the appropriate tool for a problem is a large part of what it means to be a MapReduce expert. And gaining this expertise takes practice. This practice can come naturally in a job environment, or you could choose to make it happen deliberately by seeking out problems and trying to solve them. But if you enjoy learning about and thinking about these patterns, you should check out that book I mentioned earlier, MapReduce Design Patterns, and you can learn more there. But now, it's time to try implementing some of these patterns in a sort of novel setting.